time, the Bureau of Economic Analysis has published GDP data for the United States' 3,113 counties. From America's least productive county, tiny Issaquena in Mississippi, to its most productive, sprawling Los Angeles County in California, the data captures the economic output of each and every one of these political subdivisions of states. And it brings me to my question this week. In 2018, America's 31 most productive counties, basically the top 1% of counties, were responsible for what share of GDP? 11%, 17%, 25%, or 32%? Stay tuned and we'll tell you. My GPS challenge this week is D. Bloomberg found that 31 counties accounted for nearly one-third of the nation's GDP in 2018. Take a look at this map. Together, these 31 counties occupy a tiny part of the United States geographically. High output is concentrated in major cities across a dozen or so industries, making urban counties the primary engines of economic growth. So while it's true that the economy is growing, only pockets of the nation are gaining significantly from that growth, while the rest are lagging behind. The BEA's economic data adds a new dimension to the discussion of America's rural-urban divide. Recall the 2016 election. Trump won about 2,600 counties, dwarfing Clinton's county count of roughly 500. But still, Clinton won the popular vote by nearly 3 million. In 2015, her 500 counties generated two-thirds of American GDP, while his 2,600 generated only one-third of the country's GDP. Growth rates are now up in the counties that voted for Trump, but Clinton's high output counties still grew faster overall. So the geographic concentration of growth has only become more extreme, which could make for another surprising election result in 2020. Thanks to all of you for being part of the program this week. I will see you next week.